The Friends of Fargo present Lake Mills in the Winter.
Thank you. Chestnuts roasting on an open fire. Jack Frost nipping at your nose. Yuletide carols being sung by a choir. And folks dressed up like Eskimos.
Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe help to make season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh. And every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly.
And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you.
And every mother's child is gonna spy.
I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92.
Thank you.
The children's breakfast with Santa at Pine Knoll.
All right. Well, I'll
put Joanne and Jill, the one in red and white here, will show you where to go.
Okay.
Three.
You better watch out, you better not cry, you better not pout, I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. He's making a list and checking it twice. He's gonna find out who's naughty and nice. Santa Claus is coming to town. He sees you when you're sleeping. He knows when you're awake. He knows if you've been bad or good, so be good for goodness sake. Oh, you better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. Tin horns and little toy drums, Rudy toot toots and rummy tum tums. Santa Claus is coming to town. And curly head dolls, the toddle and coo, elephants, boats, and kitty cars too. Santa Claus is coming to town. The kids in girl and boy land will have a jubilee. They're gonna build a toy land all around the Christmas tree. So you better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town.
The winter solstice, the shortest day of the year, is also the day in which the sunrise migrates further south before returning to a more easterly direction. This fact was known to the ancient Indians at Aztlan, who utilized it probably to synchronize their various religious ceremonies. It seems probable that they used the most northern mound at Aztlan Park observation point, looking southeastward from there to Christmas Hill, the most prominent hill in that direction. The sun can be observed rising directly behind the hill on the day of the solstice. That the Indians utilized this hill is confirmed by a dirt mound they constructed on the west side of the hill, and which is identified here by a light flashing at its site. A group of persons assembled on this mound to observe the solstice on a Sunday, but because of cloudy conditions, the sun was not visualized, and therefore the second recordings are on Monday, when the sun is seen to rise over Christmas Hill.
It's going to be enormous.
I've got the woodchuck hole, and it's rising over the pier.
I thought that ridge was much higher on that hill.
A lot of trees on there, you see.
Yeah.
Ways in which we celebrate Christmas.
Thank you. Thank you.
Centennial Ice Ridge running across Rock Lake. The indoor sport of bowling. And Tuesday night, dart ball.
Check it out.